check back in with Chief Meteorologist Curtis Kurtz. This is shaping up to be just a truly brutal night outdoors, Curtis.
Yeah, lots of snow out there. The wind's going to pick up a bit. Temperatures are not outrageous, but there are some of those in store in your 8-day forecast. But still single-digit wind chills. Keep that in mind. North winds 13, the actual temperature 20 degrees with snow falling. I think high travel impact overnight because of the snow and the blowing snow, especially from the metro east and south. Wednesday, medium travel impact because of blowing snow early. There'll be sunshine fairly quickly on Wednesday. And then Thursday night, not going to provide too many problems driving wise, but if you would have a problem with your car, we expect brutal, brutal wind chills Thursday night into Friday morning. Look at this I-80 near Mitchellville, our plow cam, and you can see I-80 there snow covered with moderate snow. Snow continues overnight. I think it'll still be snowing at 5 a.m. Should taper after that. Later part of the commute should be dry, and then that sunshine moving in by 11 a.m. This would be additional snowfall. Again, the metro already about 2 to 3 inches, but you can see there's some more snow on the way. Higher amounts would be east and southeast, already really coming to an end as you head off to the northwest. You can see the snow continuing to move north. It hasn't done a whole lot north of Highway 30 in about the last hour, but reports out of Story County of about 1.8 inches of snow on the ground. And you can see extreme southeastern Iowa, it's still raining down there. Warm enough for rain over in Keokuk and Fort Madison. Snow across Wisconsin, the back edge of the system already moving through Nebraska. The area of low pressure will move to the northeast, will dry out tomorrow, and this Arctic air is building in behind, and that is going to punch in here to finish out the week. So here we go, hour by hour. There'll be one band of snow overnight that may punch as far north as Highway 20. Then the back edge of that squeezes out the snow, moves out of the metro around 7 a.m. and should push out of the state around the noon hour, and then we'll clear out the rest of the day on Wednesday. Here's what it looks like for statewide snowfall out there. And you can see not a tremendous amount of snow on the way. Wait for those totals to move on up. The computer running just a bit behind on that. But again, northwest, not much more snow on the way, and a little more snow here in the metro, more to the east and southeast. Sunshine breaks free tomorrow, 19 degrees in Indianola, partly cloudy skies, 19 in Creston, 20s over in Red Oak. A west-northwest wind blowing through Pocahontas and Algona. It looks like morning snow showers, Eldora, Toledo, and then temperatures tomorrow topping out at 20 in Ottumwa and 19 degrees in Sheraton. Tonight, snow and blowing snow. It's been the story. 13 degrees, northwest winds 15 to 25. Snow early tomorrow. It should clear fairly quickly. 19 degrees out there. Sun goes down at 5:19. Dry Thursday. It is late Thursday night into Friday morning. I'm expecting life-threatening wind chills out there. It's going to be brutal. Saturday 14, starting out at 10 below, less wind. Warms up Sunday with some snow showers. And then look at Tuesday, Wednesday next week. Single digits for highs.